Crucified thee for me, kind Jesus. We are so pleased that you are here for our Holy Week meditation. I'd like to share this beautiful meditation written by Vince Amlin. Vince is co-pastor of Bethany UCC in Chicago. If I had known then, in the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent by God to a town in Galilee called Nazareth, to a virgin engaged to a man whose name was Joseph. Of the house of David, the virgin's name was Mary, Luke 1:26 and 27. Maybe you, like me, are surprised to find yourself reading the story of Gabriel and Mary during Lent. In other traditions, today is a feast of the Annunciation, March the 25th, 9 months to the day till Christmas. It's strange, this close to the end of the story, to be reminded how it begins. It makes me wonder whether, if Mary had known then what she knows now, she would still have said, "Let it be with me according to your word." After Simeon told her a sword would pierce her heart, after Herod killed all those other little boys, after Jesus motioned to one of his crowds and said, "This is my real mother and brothers," after so much suffering and before still more, could she have mustered such a faithful response? We can't know. But reading this story in Lent reminds us that one thing is certain. For God, the answer is yes. Even with the end so near, even knowing how it will turn out, even with the suffering, the betrayal, the cross, God says, "I would do it again, to join you, to love you, to save you. I would do it all again. I am doing it all again." Let us pray. O come, Emmanuel. In this Holy Week, may we remember all of those suffering, all of them, all the souls that need you, God. We think of all the people that have been through tragedy in these last couple of years. We are with them. We are with you, God. May we be ever mindful of your love and what you did to save us. Amen. Thank you so much for being here. On behalf of Jack and myself, I wish you a very peaceful and blessed Holy Week. Bye-bye.